Hi, today I'd like to talk to you guys about doing deep sky astrophotography with the ZWO ASI174 monochrome camera. A few months ago, I was able to do my review of planetary imaging using this camera along with the RGB filters to create a color image. I've been pretty pleased with how it works with planetary, but I'm very curious to see how it works with deep sky astrophotography. It allows its shutter to stay open for around 16 minutes, which is plenty long enough to do a guided image of any deep sky target that's in the night sky. So to do this, I'm going to have to use my RGB filters, but I'm also going to be inside the city of Dallas, Texas when I do this, and there's going to be considerable light pollution. So I'm going to need a light pollution filter, which I just so happen to have right here. This little filter is the Orion sky glow filter, and it's a moon and sky glow filter, so theoretically I should be able to use it during a night where the moon's out. Now, I've tried putting this into the filter wheel in such a way that I can use it with the camera and cycle the filters. The first place that I tried to put it here was to screw it in the back of the nose piece for the filter wheel itself, which it threads in very well, like so. The problem is that once you've got it threaded into the nose piece, and you go to thread the nose piece into the camera, when you thread the nose piece into the filter wheel, you get it threaded in, when you go to change your filters, you can't. It collides with them. So I had to think of another place that I could put it. Naturally, the same position on the camera would work out quite well, actually. So here's the nose piece to the camera. And if I take that filter out, like so, and I were to thread it in the back of the camera's nose piece, and then thread this into the camera, I'm almost able to thread it all the way down. I don't know, but you can see that there's just this small gap right there. It's not quite perfectly all the way down. What that means is that my filter is now pressing against the body of the camera here. We don't necessarily want that. For some reason, it may not want to sit flat or whatever, and then you may get an off angle for the light plane hitting the image sensor. So finally I decided that the best place for this filter to belong at is actually when you remove it from here and thread it at the opening of the nose piece. Oops. So threading the filter on the front of the nose piece of the camera like this actually gives you the best placement for it. And there's a reason for that. Go ahead and put the nose piece for the filter wheel back on. We're able to slide this in almost all the way, tighten it down. And now when you go to move the filter wheel, you might be able to hear that it's dragging against the filter itself, the light pollution filter. To get around that, we're going to slightly loosen the brass compression ring, back the camera out just a little bit, tighten everything back down, and then when we move that filter wheel, you don't hear it scraping anymore. And that's what we want. Now, the other reason why having the filter placed all the way at the front of the nose, right behind the filters inside of the filter wheel, is as the light moves from the telescope into the filter wheel, it's going to pass through an RGB filter. And then from there, it's going to pass immediately through the light pollution filter. And if we had too much distance between the two, I'm afraid what I would encounter is a lot of vignetting from one filter being cast onto the other filter, and then that itself will cause vignetting when it hits the imaging sensor itself, and I'm going to lose a lot of data in the edges of my field of view. So putting the two filters as close as I can to one another should hopefully eliminate the effects of that vignetting from going from one filter to the next. Now, using these light pollution filters inside of the city does change the characteristics of the light that I'm going to be imaging, mainly the intensity of each wavelength. While I'm doing the red, the green, and the blue channels, I'm going to be subtracting a significant amount of that light for the light pollution as well, using that light pollution filter. The result is my image should be slightly green, or slightly blue, or somewhere in between bluish and green. Hopefully post-processing will be able to correct all of that using Photoshop or PixInsight by doing some sort of white balance. Should be able to bring everything back into a better color balance in the final image. So tonight's looking like it's going to be moderately clear. However, I have noticed that there are some thin high clouds moving in. So tonight may not be the night that I get to do this. However, there's plenty of clear nights this week that I should be able to go set up. If not in my own driveway, I might be able to go to the city park just down the road and set up out there where it's a little darker and I can get away from some of the street lights and the back patio lights that could also influence the final results of my testing with this. So I hope to see you out in the field here pretty soon. Bye.